Hey, what's up, everyone? My name is Jamal Bowman, and this is The First Time. Oh, I don't know. You know, usually I post things and I don't really follow them. I don't know what viral means. I mean, I know it means a lot of people watched it and shared it. You know what I'm saying? So viral for vibing, I just started really, really vibing maybe the last month or so of the campaign. I think vibing might have been the tweet that was literally, I think we literally titled it vibing, just vibing. That was the day I got the call that we were going to receive the Elizabeth Warren endorsement. And I was sharing my reaction with our staff. And, you know, Wayne Wonder, you know, No Letting Go just happened to be on the radio. And I just turned it up and started vibing. September 1999 is the first time I taught a class. It felt magical. I felt like I found my home. Teaching is still the thing I probably love more than anything else. So we lived in a two-bedroom apartment. I have two older sisters who introduced me to hip-hop. And in their bedroom, they had this small pink radio. And I remember they had this like mixtape. And the song was The Show by Dougie Fresh and Slick Rick. Also, if you didn't know, this is called The Show. And it was just like a moment where I felt like I was transported to a place of like complete bliss and euphoria. And it's like a feeling that never went away. It's like I still have that feeling, not just when I listen to hip hop, but in terms of my just overall engagement and disposition with the world around me. So pretty astounding sort of feeling. I used to go to a lot of the nightclubs as a kid, maybe nightclubs I shouldn't have been in as a 15, 16 year old. It was this club in the Bronx, and I remember they put on the song Protect Your Neck. Yo, the best protect your neck. And the club wasn't really popping that much that night, but they put on the song Protect Your Neck. And I remember the line, you know, swinging through your town like a neighborhood Spider-Man. Swinging through your town like a neighborhood Spider-Man. So that had to be the first time. And so this was when Protect Your Neck was still like, you know, this is when it was like the, you know, it was the raw, uncut circulation of this tape with this song on it. The rest is history, man. Wu-Tang forever, Wu-Tang all day. Campaigning during the pandemic, wearing a Wu-Tang mask. It came full circle for me. I think it was when I was 11. You know, it was the time where, me and my friends were just hanging out, horse playing, being kids, having a good time. And I guess we were making too much noise or something. And I don't know if someone called the police or they just approached us on their own. But they approached us like, you know, calm it down. You know, what's going on over here? And I remember giving some back talk. And next thing I knew, you know, I was grabbed. I was thrown against the wall. I was thrown on the ground, face scraped across the ground, nightstick to the back, like it was just crazy. So I was 11 years old then. And after all of that, they took us to the precinct, laughed it up with us, you know, in the precinct, you know, because we were kids. We just wanted to go home. We didn't want to get in any further trouble. And they just let us home. So there wasn't even any charges or anything and any consequences for them because my mom and I didn't follow up. It was so ever present that it was never like a first time I noticed it. It was kind of like just there, like ubiquitous, you know? I remember being a kid and, you know, I had two older sisters. My sisters are like 10 years older than me and 10 and 11 years older than me. And one time some girl came to our apartment, knocked on the door and asked my sisters to come down for a fight. And we went downstairs and, you know, my sisters fought this girl. I don't remember if my sisters won or lost, but I remember going downstairs. There was this huge crowd And, you know, my sisters had this fight. And my sisters used to date like drug dealers as well. And I remember a drug dealer hiding guns in my mom's apartment. Now I'm like in fifth or sixth grade. And my focus is video games. Like I used to play Nintendo all the time. So I'm in the room playing Nintendo and this guy hides guns in the apartment. And I remember him taking me what upon reflection, it might've been a drug deal, but I was a young kid. He took me with him. I believe we went to the Bronx, and when we were in the Bronx, he pulled out a gun, shot it in the air and asked me if I wanted to shoot too. I was like, hell no. You know, I didn't even want to touch it. Like I didn't want any parts of that. But like, I mean, this was the crack cocaine era, right? So there was guns and drugs and violence everywhere. So it just seemed ever present. You know, the first time for me where like I started getting into fights, it might've been like sixth grade, you know, and you know, this is pre-adolescence, you know, middle school. So this is where like, you know, hormones are just out of control. And yeah, it could be something as simple as, you know, someone looks at you the wrong way, you look at them the wrong way, and next thing you know, you're in a fight. You know, like for no reason. That's something that came to be over a lifetime of learning and experiences. And over time throughout this campaign, we released it on a Monday, I believe. We wrote it that previous week, which is pretty much a sort of amalgamation of things that we were part of our criminal justice agenda. Things I've said and talked about during the campaign, as well as pulling from Ayanna Presley's People Justice Platform. Oh, man.
But you know what Donald Trump is more afraid of than anything else? Black man. A black man with power.
What I know for a fact is I'm not afraid of him, and we ain't afraid of him. That's number one. And we're going to let that be known on a consistent basis throughout this campaign. And the thing about bullies is they're incredibly emotionally insecure, and they need trauma-informed care. But sometimes a bully, especially someone like Trump in this context, just needs to be confronted very aggressively and often to be put in their place. So, you know, that'll be part of the work going forward as well.